A 3-year-old girl shot while outside her Avondale home at 2:30 in the morning. It is one of the most viewed stories on our website, WLWT.com. She was caught in the crossfire. Good evening, I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you, I'm Cherie Palello. Bullets were just flying outside her home along Tacoma Avenue. But what was she doing outside in the middle of the night? WLWT News Source Brian Hamrick is leading the way for us. He joins us live from the scene tonight. Brian.
Yes, Cherie, well, I asked police that specific question. They're trying to sort all of this out. There was some talk that someone from the house may have been putting out some garbage, and maybe this young girl wandered out after them, but they aren't sure about that yet. Let me just show you where this all happened. See this apartment complex in behind there? That's where the garbage cans are. Now, police say this is where the girl was, but most of the shooting was on top of the hill in front of this other apartment up here. Now, they're still trying to sort out if this was one person shooting, if people were shooting each other, but they do know it set off a night of chaos here. Left behind is a trail of shell casings and a path of destruction for those like Marquita Sanders.
I heard my kids jump up and say they were shooting, because the shooting happened back there, but my kids' room was that.
Things went from bad to worse.
Next thing you know, I just hear my next door neighbor come out like, they shot my baby, they shot my baby.
3-year-old Leah Johnson was hit by a bullet that went in her backside and exited her abdomen. Police saturate the apartment complex, but suddenly the situation intensifies.
There's a SWAT call up here on Irving Avenue, reference a shooting in which a 3-year-old little girl was shot.
SWAT teams are called on to surround an apartment where witnesses saw activity at the time of the shooting. Eventually, 6 people, men, women, and juveniles come out and are taken in for questioning, leaving police to sort out what happened.
First of all, we don't have any reason to believe that the child was a target.
Cincinnati Police Captain Mike Neville says they believe the child was hit by a stray bullet. While they've collected lots of shell casings, no gun.
We keep going back to make sure that there is nothing missed.
And for now, investigators don't know of any connection between the family of Leah Johnson and anyone being questioned. Now, the young girl is still in the hospital, we're told, in the critical care unit, and police say she's on a ventilator at this time. So far, none of the people that are being questioned have been arrested. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, WLWT News 5.